Hi guys, so today we're gonna talk a little bit more about the shapes of the body and contrast level. If you haven't seen my video, 5 types of contrast, you probably wanna watch that because we're gonna talk about this today. Also, you can check my video, 7 ways of how you can change your contrast level. I'm gonna link those videos down below so you would check them. What I will tell you today will be probably the way number 8, how you can change the contrast of your look. Not directly, not in colors, but as far as it's part of the look, we can use this as number 8. It doesn't connect to the contrast level literally, because contrast level is something connected to the colors and to the depth of colors. And when we talk about the shapes, it's not about the colors. But when the shape is about colors, when we talk about shadows, shadow is just a different color. What kind of shadows we're talking about? Because the woman that is in the studio is being photographed, it's a different situation from the woman who is just cooking at home, for example. In both cases, she has shadows. Everywhere where is light, there is shadows. Shadows, they outline the object. That's why we see the shape of the objects, because of those shadows. I will show you very quick how that works and why some bodies and some features can look more contrasted or less contrasted. Of course, in different situations with different lighting, it varies all the time. However, the shadows can look a little bit similar. We have 2 different sources of light, outside and the lamps inside. And normally with artificial light, we have more defined shadows. Whether it's outside, the space is huge, so the sun is shining on the whole surface, on this huge area. This light reflects from all the surfaces, from down there, from the road, from the trees, from everywhere. So it kind of lightens up all those places so you don't have as harsh shadows, but you still have them. I'm not gonna go too deep into the subject of shadows, objects and stuff. The only thing I'm gonna show you is if the feature on the face or on the body is sharp or prominent, has more thin, more coming forward shape, the shadow will be thinner and darker. If the surface is wider, more rounded and more flat, then the shadow is gonna be lighter, more blended, and take a bigger area. I like this example very much. Diana Kruger, she has very sharp features on her face. Therefore, the shadows on her face, in many cases, even outside sometimes, or inside in the studio, when she's being filmed or photographed, we can see that the shadows are pretty thin and pretty dark. This is what's happening because she has that very narrow nose here and very sharp nose here. So the shadow here is not blurred and blended and big. It's very thin and narrow. Let me show in Photoshop how I can remove that thin shadow a little bit with lighter color. So I'm taking her skin color and I'm making it slightly transparent and I'm kind of removing that very thin line on her nose. This way her nose becomes softer and wider and the surface of her nose looks more flat like that. Many Asian faces, for example, they have pretty flat surface on their face, so they almost don't have any shadows sometimes by their nose here, because the nose is pretty flat and many of the noses are pretty rounded. They do have sometimes sharper noses, prominent noses, but many of them have that flat surface and flat cheekbones, so therefore you can hardly find any shadows on their faces. Just compare this face to this face, for example, how much less shadows she has. Softness, rounded chin, not very sharp bone structure. So the bone structure that is softer, wider, rounder, and more flat, that looks less contrasted just because it doesn't have those prominent features that can drop the shadow on the side. Now, what is the shadow? The shadow is also the color. The shadow has the color. What kind of color that is? So basically the surface where the shadow is lying on, this surface changes its color. So the shadow would be same color but darker and plus some gray to it. I'm gonna show you now. Here's the background. How can I find a right shadow color for this particular surface? So let's find this color first. This is here. You can see that very clear light color, light blue, let's say. So how can I find the shadow color for this one? It's gonna be just darker and it is gonna be more to the gray side, between gray and black, somewhere there. So I'm picking this color and I put the circle in there and you can see that this is a perfect shadow. I created the shadow. Let's see what will be the color of the shadow on the skin color. So we can see there is a skin color. So the shadow would be somewhere more to the gray side and darker. So I'm picking this color and here we can see that perfect shadow color for this color. Shadows can be very different. It depends on the source of light, how powerful the light is, where's the source of light and all that thing. So if the source of light is super small, in a dark room, so the shadow will be very black. If the source of the light is very like everywhere, it's reflecting from many surfaces, then the shadows are gonna be much more blurred and blended, much light grayer color, I would say. When we look at the person anywhere, we do see those shadows. Those shadows kind of create the shape of this person. That's why we can recognize the features. That's why we can recognize the person, basically. So if the shadows are very blended, take bigger area and they are lighter, that means that this person has served their bone structure. And actually that will help you much more when you are trying to find out your body type. So we also are talking about body shapes, body types. That is why it's connected. This is why the recommendations for certain body types work. That also influences on the contrast of the person. Let's say Beyonce, she has very soft features, very soft nose. You can see here, she normally contours her nose, making it thinner and sharper. But on this picture, she has no makeup, looks like she doesn't. So she has that very soft shadows around her nose. Her nose is pretty flat and it's very rounded and slightly wide, right? So it's not sharp like Diana Kruger, for example. So in Beyonce's case, what we can do, if we take thinner shadows, we place it on the sides of her nose and immediately the nose looks more prominent, more sharp. This is how we created the contrast in the shape of her face, right? We added that contrast in there by adding some shadows to her face. This is what we're doing with contouring as well. We are creating more contrast in our shape. So same with the lips. Lips can be sharper or lips can be softer. Same with the tip of the nose. How we can also understand that Diana Kruger's nose is very sharp by that light spot. You know the theory behind the contouring. So everything that is light is coming forward visually, like creates an illusion of coming forward. Everything that is darker is coming back. It kind of shrinks. So same with her nose. She has that very small light spot right on the tip of her nose. That gives us the idea that she has a sharp nose. Let me make that spot darker, or let's say bigger. So we immediately lose the perception of that sharp feature on her face. This is why some girls, they like to put that little spot of shimmer right on the tip of their nose, because it makes their nose look sharper. And some girls don't like it. They like their nose to be softer, more flat. Therefore, they would have put a bigger amount of it on the whole tip of the nose, so the tip will kind of be bigger and rounder in general. Or they didn't do anything at all. Let me show you on Beyonce's case. So if I apply some light spot right in the center, small spot, should be small, you can see how her nose becomes sharper right away. So this is also the theory behind the plastic surgery. Some women are trying to add the contrast with the plastic surgery on them. With fillers, some women try to blend some of their shadows. They want to make their face, I don't know, chin, nose, slightly rounder, so the shadows will be more blended. I don't know what exactly influenced on them, so they think that that would look more attractive with that, but this is just what basically they want sometimes. But some women, on contrary, they want more chiseled look. They want thinner shadows, so therefore they can remove some fat from the cheeks, fillers on their cheekbones. They are making fillers on their chin, so it would be more pointed. They can even make fillers now to their noses to make the nose look more sharp. This is all creating those prominent features. And those prominent features, they drop darker and thinner shadows normally. Or they just want soft but prominent features. So they put a lot of like lip injections, cheek injections, all that is still rounded, but the shadows underneath are bigger. They're not necessarily smaller because it's not sharp, right? But they are bigger and they are darker. That also creates a certain shape. For some reason, that is just more attractive to them. Maybe they want to look like somebody. Maybe they have this idea that probably they will look more attractive with that. But that's just how it works. It's kind of same like some women create contrast with their hair color or with something else, or they remove some contrast because for them it looks too harsh, you know? Alright, that's it. Thank you so much for watching. Happy New Year for you guys. Just wanted again to throw some positive vibe for you for 2020. I hope this year will be wonderful for you. All I want is you to be sure that you look amazing. If you love some retro music, some classic rock, you're welcome to subscribe on my music channel as well. You can also support me on Patreon. That would be a huge help for me. I upload some exclusive videos there sometimes and I answer your questions there, so please welcome. You can subscribe on my Instagram for just random stuff from my music and from my makeup life. You can also subscribe on my Pinterest, where I have 13 boards as an inspiration for each body type. It might help you to get a better idea about the body types in general. Alright, I'm gonna see you very soon. Bye bye.